we're out handing out leaflets for people to vote for the first free Iraqi elections in January of 05. And we were given the mission at the last minute to deliver medical supplies to a medical facility in the Palestine region of southern Mosul. Picked up the mission, dismounted the vehicle about 150 meters short of the building, and there's about 8 to 10 guys on second and third story roofs that started shooting at us because we were at the funnel of the alleyway. The platoon leader was killed by a lone sniper, and he was shot through his left armpit, came out through his right side, so he was dead before he hit the ground. He was like class valedictorian of his college class. He spent 5 years as a commo guy and then went to college, became an infantry officer. At first, you don't want to believe it. It doesn't even go through your head because, you know, first thing that you're taught in the Army is to your ABCs. It was like 36 hours later, we got word that the janitor of that mosque, because the sniper shot from a minaret, knew where the guy lived. And so he's got information about the Army soldier that was shot and killed in Palestine. And then we were actually given the green light to go after the individual that killed him. That was real tough. There was a lot of conversation about what we were going to do to that individual, physical harm to him, and you know, things we wanted to do to him. We didn't think he should live. And it wasn't any glorified Bible saying an eye for an eye, you know, hand for a hand or anything. It was just he had killed one of ours, so we think we should do the same to him.